Today we're going to be taking a look at the best hitches available for the 2007 Lexus RX 350. Here we've got our Curt. This is a Class 3 hitch, part number 13530. Followed by the Draw-Tite, also a Class 3, part number 75153. Now from a few feet away, the hitches are going to look very, very similar to one another, with the exception maybe of the drop down. This is designed to accommodate our exhaust. It goes down and around the exhaust rather than having to remove that or lower it. You can see the Curt, it's going to be a little bit narrower than what we've got on the Draw-Tite. The Draw-Tite gap here is just a little bit bigger, so might want to keep that in mind. Both hitches are going to have the round tubes. Both hitches mount exactly the same way. They're going to go right up onto the frame, three holes on each side, already existing weld nuts will thread right in. Really a pretty simple hitch to put in place, no modifications necessary whatsoever. Now if we look a little closer at them, we're going to have a few minor differences that we can go over now. See our Curt, it's going to have the flush style reinforcement collar here on the end, where the Draw-Tite, it's going to be just a little bit more rounded. Also, you'll notice on the Draw-Tite hitch, the safety chain connection point is a plate style connector. Nice large openings, but it's on top of the receiver tube opening. That's kind of opposite of what you typically see. Typically, those are going to be on the bottom, like what we have here with our Curt. You see it also has openings that are slightly smaller than what's on the Draw-Tite, so if you're using larger hooks, the Draw-Tite might be the way to go. The thing I like about the safety chain connection point on our Draw-Tite, since this does come out from the rear, the bumper slightly, it actually acts as a step. You could step on this to access the roof if you have a cargo basket or box or something like that on top of the vehicle. The hole setups in the side of the receiver tube openings are a little bit different too. You'll see we're going to have two holes here on the Draw-Tite. The one that's located closer to the front of the vehicle, it's a larger hole. That's the one we want to use to secure all of our items with. It's 5/8 of an inch in diameter. We want to be sure to use Class 3 rated accessories, but there's going to be plenty of room there on each side for anti-rattle devices, locking hitch pins and clips, or just standard pins and clips. The smaller hole that's located a little bit closer to the rear of the vehicle there, that's for use only with the J-pin stabilization system. The Curt is going to have a single pin hole. It's 5/8 of an inch in diameter as well. Class 3 accessories, of course. And you'll see on the back side of the hole there, it's a little limited on space, so devices that use the larger washers might not work so well without those kind of being tilted a little bit, and eventually they just kind of bend into position. So minor difference there. Now when it comes to weight ratings on our hitches, the Curt has a 350-pound tongue weight rating. That's the maximum downward force we can put here in the receiver tube opening. And it offers a 3,500-pound gross trailer weight rating. That would be the total weight of our trailer and anything that we were to load up on it. If we move down to the Draw-Tite, it's going to be exactly the same. 350 pounds and 3,500 pounds. Now, nice thing about the Curt, it is rated for use with weight distribution. That's going to increase our tongue weight up to 400 pounds and the gross trailer weight up to 4,000 pounds when using spring bars. The Draw-Tite is not rated for weight distribution. Now, of course, we want to check the owner's manual on the Lexus, see what it's rated for, and then go off of whichever of those sets of numbers are the lowest. Now, this is what our Curt's going to look like installed. As you can see, it's going to remain visible across the rear of the vehicle there. Got that drop down that we talked about earlier to go down and around the exhaust. Now, visually with the hitches, if you want one that's going to be as close and as tucked into the car as possible, the Curt's the way to go. This only really sticks out about an inch past the end of the bumper. Whereas with the Draw-Tite, it's going to be an inch and a half further out. It's going to be at 2.5 inches, and then we've got that plate up there. Now, when choosing the right hitch for your application, they're both Class 3 hitches. They're both going to be very, very versatile. If you plan on using a weight distribution setup, you need to go with the Curt. This is the only one rated for weight distribution. If you're just using standard trailer duty, bike racks, cargo carriers, things like that, either one's going to do a good job. I like that the Draw-Tite being a little bit further out is going to get the cargo carriers, if it's a folding design, or bike racks if it's a tilt-away design, it gets that a little bit further out to give us more room to get into the rear hatch. So I think if I were going to be buying one, if I didn't care about the plate being on top and it being a little further out, I'd go with the Draw-Tite. If you want the cleaner, kind of closer to the vehicle looking one, I think the Curt's the way to go. And of course, like we said, if you need to use weight distribution, you need to go with the Curt. And that's going to complete our look for the best hitches available for the Lexus RX 350. We hope this will make your decision just a little easier to make.
Click the link below to shop, learn more, or visit us at etrailer.com.